Hey everybody, how's everybody doing out there? I hope great. Today we have a requested story, and I'm glad you all are here. In 2016, Beyonce immersed on country music on Lemonade's, okay? Daddy's Lessons. Later it was covered by the Dixie Chicks. Okay. She appeared at the Country Music Awards with the Dixie Chicks, and the fans had a mixed reaction. Beyonce has a new single from her up-and-coming album, Act Two, Texas Hold'em is the name, which is Beyonce's work honoring the legacy of Black artists. Renaissance was celebrated, let me rephrase that. Renaissance celebrated the history of club music, where Black and queer people found safe spaces and solidarity, okay? She reminds her listeners that country music is another kind of dance music, okay? You know she can dance. Bae threads the history of dance, connecting culture and race. That's right. Beyonce announced her new album on Instagram during the Super Bowl broadcast. The week she appeared at the 66th Grammy Awards, she wore a cowboy hat, foreshadowing a country turn. Listen. No one paid any attention. The stars give indications to their next move, but if you don't pay any attention, you'll miss it. So the album arrives March the 29th. It is one of two singles alongside 16 Carriages, okay, which was released during the Super Bowl. And let's give credit where credit is due. Canadian artist Lowe co-wrote the country dance track with Beyonce. The song was a surprise release. Texas Hold'em is an up-tempo country pop and western song featuring elements of folk and soul. Music critics has praised the single for its playful tone, authentic sound, Bae's vocal performance, and its celebration of the Black roots of country music. Industry experts have speculated Beyonce is using the incursion into country to shed light on the often overlooked contributions to the genre made by Black artists. For instance, Gus Cannon, Gus was a Black musician who helped popularize jug bands in the 1920s, and he is the one who taught Johnny Cash. Nearly 50 African Americans, singers, and musicians appeared on commercial hillbilly records. Because the music was not a white agrarian tradition, but a fluid phenomenon passed back and forth between the races. After World War I, hillbilly music was officially rebranded as country music and commercialized. Big record labels wanted to sell country music, but could not if it was integrated. Black artists or previous famous records received no recognition. And the covers were sold with white stand-ins. All of a sudden, country music became marketed as white music. This sounds like to me, guys, exactly what the Temptations went through when they were replaced with the white group. They took their song and rebranded it for the white group. And the Temptations received no royalties. Black artists, musicians and their contributions were effectively erased in the white mainstream from their own genre. Black artists that have been the foundation in making the country music what it is today cannot be forgotten, though. I have two more examples for you guys before I get out of here. DeFore Bailey was one of the first black musicians to gain recognition and was the first to play the Grand Ole Opry, which is a big deal for country musicians. Then we have Charlie Pride. He was the first black artist to be inducted into the Country Music Hall of Fame. He is country music's number one black superstar. Well, let's see how well Beyoncé is recognized into country music. She's broken all other barriers. Although we popularize country music, it's viewed as white music. And here's my tea with some shade. Y'all know Beyoncé gonna tear that shit up. She do it better than anyone, in my opinion. She is the top performer. I said it and I meant it. Before I go, I got my three questions for y'all. Number one, excuse me. Oh, and I'm sipping. Excuse me, it is Friday. I'm sipping a little bit. I ain't gonna tell y'all what's in my cup, but I got something in there. Number one. Whew. And strong, too. Did y'all hear the song? Beyonce's song, Texas Hold'em? Or 16 Carriages? If y'all did, what are y'all thoughts? Put it in the comments. Did y'all think she was gonna swerve into country? I knew she was always interested in it. I wasn't sure, but I knew she was interested in it. And number three, have you guys ever heard of Gus Cannon? Did you? Probably not, because he was back in the 1920s. Anyhow, did y'all know country, did y'all country lovers know he was the one who taught Johnny Cash? Let me know that in the comments. All right, you guys have a great day. That's my take on what's in the media, a little schooling for y'all to let y'all know a little history about country music. That was requested of me. Like, share, subscribe. Turn on your bell notification so you can be notified every time I upload a video, okay? You guys have a nice day. Don't allow anyone to steal your joy.